Hi viewers, today we are going to talk about PGS and PGT. Many people are talking about now PGS and PGT. PGS is pre-implantation genetic screening. PGD is pre-implantation genetic diagnosis. What is the difference in PGS when you don't have any specific genetic diagnosis and you are going for because of the age factor or previous pregnancy loss? If you have previous recurrent miscarriages, you can still choose to have this PGS. PGS so that we will be screening your embryos generally for certain common chromosomal abnormalities. Once we know that there are some abnormalities, then we'll go further into that. So aneuploidy risk is very common when the women age is increasing. Even the men after 40 years, we are seeing that aneuploidy risk is increasing. That is where that the role of PGS is coming. Next, PGD is where the person knows the genetic abnormalities, whether they have a family history or they had a previous baby affected with Duchenne muscular dystrophy, or sometimes they have a thalassemia major, or their baby is affected with a Down syndrome. There are common conditions, lot of genetical abnormalities are already they are known, or the parents are carrier of the disease and they diagnose the carrier status, then we go for PGD. We will do mutation analysis of the parents. Once we know that what exact abnormality is there, and for that we'll be going and testing in the embryo. So we will know that if common abnormality is there, we'll go and test generally. If they have a specific mutation, then we go to the lab, the specific probe will be identified and then done for them, and to rule out whether the baby is carrying the disease or not. So like thalassemia, we do commonly with thalassemia parents and carrier parents and Duchenne muscular dystrophy, where we will be testing the parents and identify who is at a high risk, and then we are testing the baby whether the embryo is cleared of the disease. So that is PGD. So this really given a hope for them. If they have a very healthy embryo, even in thalassemia patients, when they have a good healthy baby, that baby can be a donor for the already affected child. So they can donate their bone marrow or stem cells for the sibling. So that is the advantage of PGD. So PGS and PGD are offered in GBR, and if you are really going for above 38 years, definitely PGS is one of the best option. Lot of papers have come up saying that the PGS and PGD are generally not done and should not be advised. Yes, of course, we don't need to go for every patient. It is mainly whoever is having a aneuploidy risk, or whoever is having a genetic abnormality or recurrent pregnancy loss, definitely this test is a really blessing. We can have a very good selection of embryo and have a healthy embryo, so that we have a high chances for pregnancy. Thank you.